Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at all things solar. I'm Warren.
And I'm Dale.
And in this video, we're going to talk about the state of the solar industry. So Dale, as our president and CEO, you're perfectly poised to have this discussion. Let's talk about both monetary and fiscal policy, how that's impacted the industry, how that's impacted us. But let's start off maybe on the fiscal side and talk about how things coming out of COVID, how things are changing in terms of inflation. What are we seeing in terms of inflation, and what are we seeing in terms of supply chain challenges?
Yeah, this is a really fascinating. We've seen our entire industry, the challenges in our industry change in the last year to 2 years. Coming out of COVID, I would say the industry was pretty healthy.
Yeah.
The challenges lay around supply chain issues, and that's common. You know, that's common among all industries, I think, just about all industries, where we're battling supply chain issues. And we've been doing that ever since COVID. It has not gone away. We've seen it change. Some components, one time difficult to find, other times other components. So that all has changed, but it has not gone away for us. It's been persistent. It's driven up costs, inflation. We've had to deal with that as we've never had to deal with it before as a company. You know, thinking back solar, we used to order the hardware. You got it delivered to the job site exactly when you're ready to install it. You didn't inventory anything because the cost of hardware may actually drop. And that has come, that model's completely gone.
Yeah.
You know, now we're talking about how much do we inventory? Can we get it to inventory it? How do we keep our crews going and stay efficient? And it's been challenging.
And what are we seeing in terms of inflation? Is that easing at all?
Yes.
Okay.
I think the short answer is yes, but that's a very short-term answer.
Sure.
I mean, we saw inflation rates in the solar industry of about 20% just in the fourth quarter of 2021.
Yeah.
And annualize that, that's 80%. I mean, it's 20% for a quarter.
Yeah.
In the first quarter of 2022 is similar again. We had that type of inflation, and it was devastating.
Sure.
You know, we had a significant backlog, very challenging for us. We're seeing that slow down. Currently, I would say the labor pressures have not. There's certainly been an inflationary side to labor costs for businesses. But on the hardware side, we've seen a little bit of plateauing through this summer into the fall. We're not quite sure where that's going to go. But right now, it's plateaued a bit.
But before we get into the inflation on electric costs, let's just talk about those labor shortages and how that's impacted or changed over the last year or so.
Yeah, well, I mean, coming out of COVID, Warren, there's a lot of people that just chose to leave the workplace.
Yeah.
And that's just the reality. There's a lot of baby boomers, people my age, that are saying, I've had enough of this.
Yeah.
And I'm going to deal with all these regulations, restrictions, whatever. They can retire and are saying, I'm going to retire. And so we've lost a significant chunk of workforce, and we've not been able to replace that. And so the challenge is to constantly build our team. And we think there's great opportunity. We think the industry's at a great spot, great opportunity ahead. But the challenge to build the team has been very severe, and it's going to stay that way.
Yeah. Back to the inflation. So we're seeing inflation start to ease a little bit short term on our hardware.
Yep.
But on the flip side, when you're evaluating a solar investment, we're seeing electricity and the cost of energy go up at higher rates than CPI.
Yeah. So, you know, in our area, natural gas is kind of the driver. And if you look at natural gas prices, they've just skyrocketed.
Yeah.
And so the utility rates, you knew that was going to happen. Utilities reacted to inflation slower than we did.
Yes.
And it really hurt us. I mean, there was a period of time there where the utility rates hadn't gone up yet. And then last spring, they just took off. And, you know, we're seeing it. We've seen increases ever since June. We're seeing significant increases. We've got one coming up for utility here in southeastern Pennsylvania. I just got an email today. I noticed it said 20% basically increase coming up December 1. So those are huge increases coming out of our utilities.
Yeah, and we're seeing that across the board almost at all of our, So let's look at, from a monetary policy perspective. We've seen the Fed raise interest rates meeting after meeting after meeting for the last several months as well, and there's no sign of that going away in the future. How's that impacting solar and businesses or even homeowners' ability to borrow or access capital to purchase solar?
I mean, it's a negative impact, Warren. I mean, we're gonna probably see a 0.75-point rise this week yet.
Yeah.
And, you know, you're talking about rates now that are pushing 6%, 7%, 8%. Significant impact on borrowing costs for anybody that's borrowing money. So I think that's going to be challenging. The flip side of that is you've got utility rates that are going up 20
right.
or more.
Yeah.
So, and particularly if people have some reserves and don't have to finance the entire project, it still makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
It's still a much better win for them to go solar.
You don't necessarily think that the increase in interest rates is going to slow down demand because you have these other variables that are really increasing demand.
Yeah, that's the way I view it.
Okay.
I mean, it's certainly going to take some people out of the market.
Sure.
They're just not going to want to pay those interest rates. But at the same time, with the additional incentives coming in, I mean, the incentives could easily, if you're talking in the commercial world, and you're talking about 10% adders to the ITC,
yeah.
A 10% adder wipes out any interest rate increase that we've just had. So it still makes a ton of sense.
So the Inflation Reduction Act is clearly going to increase demand for solar with these adders.
Warren, the other interesting thing about this is if you're borrowing money for solar and you're getting a significant chunk back in year one, that takes away a lot of that burden. And on the commercial side, we're going to see some really fast paybacks coming with these higher ITCs.
Yeah. And so what are some of the challenges? And so knowing that we're seeing this increasing demand, even in the face of higher interest rates, what are some of the challenges that you see from this increased demand?
Yeah, I actually was contacted by one of our vendors yesterday asking me, what do I see for 2023?
Yeah.
And what I told him was, he could be a problem, and hiring people could be a problem.
Yeah.
And I said, he could deal with the one problem by helping us secure supply. Yeah. Because it's going to be supply connected, and it's going to be labor connected. Can we build the team fast enough? We see demand for solar increasing rapidly in 2023.
Yeah. All right, Dale. So assuming we're able to figure out these two challenges in terms of labor and supply.
Right.
Are the utilities and the grid able to keep up with the demand?
Yeah, they're not.
Okay.
I mean, you look at PJM, and PJM has put some moratoriums on new applications for large utility-scale projects. So, that's kind of like a warning sign saying we're not ready.
Yeah.
There's too much going on. So I think there's going to be a utility drag. Some utilities are in much better position than others, and they're utilities we work with. Some of them, typically co-ops, maybe not quite as ready. But there's others that have embraced the renewable future, distributed generation, and they're doing a good job. Requirements have increased from utilities, which has driven up costs of renewable energy of systems. But if you're getting large percentage tax credits, grants, whatever might be happening there, it can offset those costs pretty quick. So utilities have passed more costs on, but I think we're prepared to handle that.
Yeah, and in addition, utilities are struggling from some of the same challenges we are in terms of the added requirements for parts and maybe transformers. They're struggling with accessing or getting supply for those.
And people. I mean, to process the applications, to do the research they need to keep the grid reliable, it's challenging.
Yeah. And so I would say to anybody who's potentially looking at solar that the sooner you get your application in, the more advantageous or the chances are that you'll get it in before some of these utilities start to not be able to install solar.
Warren, certainly, because you're talking development time in the past has been, we used to talk 3 to 6 months.
Right.
Now, for some of these commercial projects, we're talking 1 to 2 years.
Which is substantial. Yeah. So what is with all of these challenges that we're facing now, labor challenges, and supply challenges, what is Paradise doing to navigate and be successful through these?
I think at a time when you have rapid change going on, you want to maintain focus and not be distracted. And Paradise has always taken the long-term approach that we're gonna build a great team, we're gonna serve our clients well, we're gonna build trust. And when you get into a period of rapid change where everything's changing, trust is huge.
Yeah.
And I think we've earned that. I think that's really important to us. I don't see us changing the way we service our customers. And, can we build our team fast enough? That's a really good question. Can we? But I think great employers are going to continue to be in demand as well. People want to work for great companies. So I think we want to keep all of that in place, not lose it, because of the chaos that might be going around us, and continue to build who we are as a company, not allow that to change. You know, we say we serve our customers by living out our core values: faith, integrity, innovation, teamwork, and stewardship. We're not going to change that. They've got to stay in place. And if we do that well, everything takes care of itself.
So that really addresses the labor side of things. What are we doing? What is Paradise doing in terms of the supply challenges?
Yeah, so we have great relationships with vendors. Yeah. And the vendors have really been supportive of us, worked well with us. I'm not going to mention their names. They'd probably like if I would. I'd give them some free marketing. But they've done a great job. And we try and provide them the information as fast as we can as to what our needs are going to be. They've done a great job of securing supply for us. It doesn't always work out. But, you know, we're also inventorying more than we used to, and we'll continue to do that. So, you know, we'll pick and choose what we need to inventory to secure it, to keep our crews going. And I think the future is very, very bright.
Great. Thank you, Dale. Thank you for your time. Thank you for watching. We hope you found this valuable. If you want to learn more about how solar could work for you, click on the link in the description below to get a quote. We'd love to show you what solar would look like for you.